Mr. Morgan, do you want a refill?
Yes. Thank you.
Is the coffee that good, Mr. Morgan?
Coffee is a vital investigative tool. I know exactly what to do now. It says to hurry, and the first letter of each line is H-A-R-R-Y. Hurry to Harry. Looks like the time that he was talking about has come. Let's go pay the problematic rich boy who owns half of the town a visit. Polly, I think I'm going to go see Harry today.
Oh, really? He's a little strange, but I think he's the most trustworthy one around here. I think you'll have fun with him.
If you say so, Polly, then we probably will.
Of course! Now, give me your cup, and I'll give you some more coffee.
I'll see you later, Polly.
Mr. Morgan! What about the coffee? Don't you want a refill? Your coffee!
Hey, am I still a suspect?
No.
Okay, well, good. My wife and I have been living separately for over 3 years now. Diane, she's a single woman, so this shouldn't be a problem.
That's true.
I feel so bad for Diane, though. Gosh, did you find out who did it?
I can't discuss that.
Yes, of course, I understand. You don't have to tell any of the folks around town about me and Diane, do you?
No, I won't do that. But it's a small town. I'm sure the rumors have started already. Nothing to be ashamed of, right? What's there to worry about?
Nothing in particular. No, nothing at all. I'm clean. As clean as the sheets in this hotel. What's with that look? We don't have a problem, right?
It looks like Kaysen is involved with another woman in town. We can only hope it isn't Emily.
Oh, hi.
York, I can't find Thomas. Was he here?
No, I haven't seen him. Have you tried the radio?
I've been trying, but he's not answering.
What about Nick?
No problem with him. He's calmed down a little. He's still saying he didn't do it. Nick said that Thomas disappeared sometime during the night. He kept calling for him, but Thomas stopped responding. I'm a bit worried. George has asked for permission to search for Thomas.
I understand that things have been hard for Thomas, but surely he's just resting at home. But I'm not against looking for him. Tell George that he has my blessing.
Okay. As far as I know, Thomas always calls in when he needs a day off.
We're human, and so we are limited. As far as you know, there haven't been any serial killings here before, right?
That's right, but that's not...
Emily, I'm going to see Harry today.
What? Why? We have plenty of other leads to follow, don't we?
He did invite me over, though. It would be bad manners not to accept.
Are you really an FBI agent? I'd think the FBI would take a more logical approach to investigations.
Oh, but Emily, serial killer does not stay within the boundaries of logic. Thus, you can't hope to capture such a killer using only logic. That's why I'm going to see Harry. You go with George and find Thomas.
Okay, sounds like a plan.
Great, thanks.
I was an idiot for thinking he might be a good pick. I really need to work on my taste in men.
Zack, we've ended up with a third victim. That dive I made at the gallery ended up being a wasted attempt to save a life. It's a real mess, Zack.
Dive. When's the last time I made a dive like that? Oh, I remember. Do you? It was in my late teens. We used to go to those concerts. You and I like punk rock, but we like different types of punk. You liked hard and heavy punk, like Crash and Sham 69. I liked the more twisted ones, like The Damned, Buzzcocks, Iggy Pop, and Joy Division. We used to talk for hours about the bands we really liked, but for some reason, neither of us listened to the Sex Pistols. I wonder why that was. Seems strange thinking about it now. You know what? There was one band that we both liked.
We went all the way to New York to see them play. Right, Zack?
It took us hours to get to New York by bus. We got to the CBGB and we were so nervous we couldn't go inside.
It took us 30 minutes to gather enough courage to go inside. And inside, we were shocked. Right, Zack?
I'll never forget that feeling. It was like a blitzkrieg. Blitzkrieg bop. The Ramones. That song still makes me feel good. And that's a sign of a classic. But it's amazing I got in without being asked for ID. Those were the good old days. Rock and roll high school and Chinese rock. Sheena is a punk rocker and surfing bird. And I was so depressed when I heard the news of the deaths. Original punk is one of the greatest gifts left from the 20th century. Let's hope they're still rocking on wherever they are.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, Mr. Stewart has been waiting for you. To the meeting room you shall go to.
The meeting room is through here. Please be kind. Be sincere. Yes?
Zack, something is still missing. We need more clues. Zack, something is still missing. We need more clues.
Yes?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please have some tea while it is hot. Too much coffee for your body will make it rot.
You seem well prepared. Almost as though you knew I would be coming today.
Mr. Stewart is particular about the best timing for all things. Now please, drink some tea and enjoy the good health it brings.
I'm sorry, Harry, but I just don't like tea.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, some tea with sugar is what's best admired.
By your body that looks so tired, so says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, where did you get these seeds?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, those seeds were found in our town, in a certain specific place.
More seeds are there, you will see, when you find that certain space. Come back to me and we shall talk, after you find that certain place. So says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, so you like to play games?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, a hint for you to find this location.
It is most crowded and most quiet, and gives a cold sensation. So says Mr. Stewart.
All right. So you're not going to talk unless I find this certain place. I'll play along. Zack, let the treasure hunt begin. A crowded place, and yet it is very quiet there. Have you figured it out, Zack? It must be the graveyard. There's lots of people there, but none of them can speak. You see? So let's get going to the graveyard.
So, Zack, about Emily. My first impression when we met her on that bridge is slightly different from what I think about her now. Don't you think she's pretty mesmerizing? And Zack, she seemed interested in you. Did you make a move on her? No, don't answer. I'm just asking. But if you like her, I won't stand in your way. But I'd like to hear the truth. Because this kind of stuff could affect our friendship, you know. Me? I'm just interested in her, that's all. It isn't love or anything. From what I can tell, she doesn't even seem to like me. It's pretty clear from how she acts when she's around me. As you know, Zack, I'm cautious with women. It's because I was badly burned in my last relationship. I really have no idea what women are thinking. That's my problem. You're pretty friendly with the ladies, aren't you, Zack? Maybe you should teach me about how to interact with women.
Just as Harry said, it's crowded and quiet. Hey, Brian.
Agent. Mr. Agent, how are you?
Not bad. I'm, just playing a little game with Harry.
Game? A game? Oh, is that fun?
We've only just started, Brian. The fun is about to begin. I'd like to ask you something, actually. Is there a tree in the graveyard that drops red seeds?
Seeds? Red seeds? That tree does. And that one. And that one, too. All red seeds.
Bullseye.
great.
Nice shot.
Zack, mission accomplished. Let's get back to Harry's. The reward better be good. But you know, about these seeds. They were right here under my nose. It's as if I was carefully carrying a bottle of water while walking in a pool.
We're learning the countryside version of common sense the hard way, Zack.
A human bone? This doesn't look related to the case, but shouldn't I let someone know? Anyway, Zack, there aren't many young women left in this town. Even Emily could be targeted next. I can't rule that out. All the more reason to catch the Raincoat Killer ASAP. And that means working closely together. We can work out the Emily situation later. Don't get me wrong, Zack. I mean, I'm not interested in Emily because she's female or anything. I'm just saying she's interesting. You know, as an interesting person. But by looking at her, she reminds me of something I used to feel. That's all. Like back when I first met you. You know, that feeling we all used to feel back when we were kids? Feeling safe while also feeling a need to protect, that kind of feeling. But Zack, who made me feel that back then? Anyways, we're getting closer one step at a time to cracking this case. I have a feeling it's going to get tough.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please proceed to Mr. Stewart's room. There he awaits you, I shall assume.
Thank you.
Harry, turns out what you said was true, and I'd like to hear more.
York, as you know, there's a powerful mystery surrounding these seeds. You've seen them at those other murders that took place elsewhere. And you've seen them deeply involved with the murders in this town.
That's right. But how do you know all this?
York, you must be younger than you look. Youngsters tend to hurry so much that they let things slip right past them.
What you need to do is slow this down a bit. That way you'll see what's really important. Let me tell you a story. 50 years ago, when the war was over, just about when the Communist Red started to become a rising threat, our town constructed a huge clock tower. Then, soon afterwards, a serial killer wearing a red raincoat went on a killing spree.
The legend of the raincoat killer? Stop playing games with me, Harry. That's nothing more than folklore. The FBI has no such record of a multiple homicide case in this town.
York, Anna, Becky, and now Diane. Their deaths are real, not folklore, not legend. The raincoat killer is also real. But under a strict gag order, mass murder case was never made public. In fact, one could say that it was completely erased from history. Tell me, who do you think would be able to do something like that?
The military.
Very good. A model student.
But if there are no records about it, then how do you know it really happened?
Good question, York. Why would I know this? The answer is very simple. I was there. I saw it with my own eyes. The brutal killer himself. But we can talk about the details of that encounter another time. What we need to talk about is your raincoat killer. The new raincoat killer, if you will. The new raincoat killer. Yes, let's call him that. After all, he's not the real one. What you want to know more about is the new one. Between 10 and 20 years ago, I noticed that these red seeds were special, and someone else did too. The human imagination can lead to tragedy sometimes. Someone linked the red seeds to the serial killer legend and said, if you eat the red seeds and then kill someone, you will become immortal. This new fabricated legend was passed on from one to the next, evolving, changing every time, like a rumor. Some may have actually taken the seeds to try them out, to prove the legend, that is.
York! Red seeds you have found from those other murders. They all came from this town, together with that one evil woman.
People on the other side of the planet may have heard of it by now. And new seeds might be growing in different parts of the world.
So you're saying that the series of cases I've been following are all linked to this town? That's interesting, Harry. But there's no evidence to support that story. None of the criminals we caught for the other murders ever mentioned anything like that.
It's your job. Your role and duty to look into that, York. Now, the game must go on. You know I said that the incident 50 years ago was totally erased. Well, not quite. Records still exist in the sheriff's office. The old sheriff back then hated the military and did his own investigation. I need you to bring those documents here to me. Once you've done that, I'll tell you everything I know.
Okay, it's worth a look. And we may as well let the old man have his fun.
Documents from a case that happened 50 years ago. Let's play along with the old man for a little longer, shall we? Zach, that means we need to head for the sheriff's department.